Je partais très bien, mais c'est pas ça qui va m'arrêter. Alors, si vous n'êtes pas capable, si vous n'êtes pas capable de mettre les trucs importantes, des choses importantes de votre vie à faire, vous n'y arriverez jamais.
This is kickboxing champion Fred Sinistra of Belgium.
Vous voulez obtenir quelque chose d'autre de votre vie? Faites du sport. Vous voulez obtenir quelque chose de votre vie? Faites des choses différentes que vous n'avez jamais fait.
Here he was working out, telling those watching that he didn't feel well, but he would continue hitting the gym. In his respective sport, he was really, really good. Like three-time world champion good. That's him in the black trunks. Then COVID hit. He wrote on Instagram that his December fight was off because he was hospitalized, though he promised to, his words, come back even stronger. Another update on his IG was a selfie from his hospital bed. The march forward has been put since I was born premature, and I will continue to fight to the death like a man without ever giving up and dying without regrets, he captioned.
She was on the phone all day long.
You may remember this video of Antonio Muradu, aka Antonio Gravaglu, a fascist who has support in the alt-right network of Italian politics, telling Joe McCarron, a man ill with COVID, he must leave the hospital.
I'm very worried about you, and I want you to stay. I think he's saying something very dangerous. What he's saying is wrong and very dangerous. I'm not lying to you, you could die, but this would be your best chance in the hospital and getting the oxygen and getting the support we're giving to you.
These people, they're lying, so we go home now, my friend. Because that's your last chance.
Because of Muradu's brain-dead conspiracies, McCarron landed back in the hospital 2 days later. He died there, thanks to Muradu and his confidants. Like Muradu, Sinistra didn't think COVID was real and chose to self-medicate. He was only admitted because his coach forced his hand. Speaking to Belgian outlet Sudinfo, Yiggin said he told Sinistra to take himself to the hospital and threatened to refuse train the former world champ in the future if he refused to do so. Per Yahoo News, Sinistra said he had decided to treat the little virus by himself at home after leaving the hospital in late November. After discharging himself from the hospital, the heavyweight fighter reportedly treated himself with oxygen at home. News Hub noted he was a vocal anti-vaxxer who held the nickname The Undertaker when competing. The athlete had previously shared a video where he could be seen struggling to breathe, saying in the caption he had no time to waste with lazy people. The anti-vaxxer said in other posts that the little virus will not stop him while raising his objections against government measures for COVID. Going through his history, the former world champion boxer had repeatedly called the virus la grippe des cheveux, literally meaning the hair flu, and blasted mask mandates and vaccine passes. Sinistra, an active member of social media, kept posting, remaining active. That was until December 13th, when he went into cardiac arrest. He would die later. This was a man who competed to this day and was an example of a human being in top physical shape. So much so, he was branded as Belgium's strongest man. What Sinistra has shown is the countless examples we have of anti-vaxxers clamoring to this myth of fitness and youth and eating right and taking care of one's own body as the remedy to treating COVID-19. It's not. Sinistra's wife would write, "From the bottom of my heart, thank you all for your support and all your wonderful tributes to my husband. My husband was a generous man with a big heart who wanted to help others no matter what." Sinistra is survived by his wife as well as his children. The saddest part may be that this all could have been avoided and another life could have potentially not been lost. Even after Sinistra, a physical specimen, did not treat COVID the way it should have been treated, which cost him his life, his wife appeared unmoved. Per Newsweek, his wife refused to admit that the anti-vax athlete died from COVID-19 complications, adding that never would he have accepted that we used what happened to him to spread fear and call for vaccination. I will fight to the end so that the truth is restored and his name is washed away from all the slanderers, both family and around his death, she said.